Good morning. Today's presentation, we are going to see about the well control formulas and some acronyms. What are the formulas utilized in well control engineering? Let's go to the presentation. So today's presentation, we are going to see about the what are the formulas in well control engineering and acronyms, formulas, etc. So these are the basic things which are utilized in the well control engineering. What are the abbreviations you can see here? Annular capacity, annular pressure loss, bottom VHA, bottom assembly, casing, coil tubing, drill collar, etc. So these are the abbreviations, acronyms which are utilized in the well control engineering. So that like EVHP, effective bottom hole pressure, ECD, equivalent circulating density, etc. EMD, FCB, final circulating pressure, then ICP, initial circulating pressure, then KMD, kill mud density, etc. Then KOPCP, kickoff point circulating pressure, KOPMD, that is kickoff point measured depth, KOPTVD, that is kickoff point true valley depth, then FLOC, percolated water, which are used in the drilling fluids. So next slide. Similarly, you can see here the other things, soil based mud, OBM, OMD, original mud density, etc. Then PVT, pit volume, totalizer. So like this, these are the acronyms and abbreviations which are used in the well control engineering. And you can see here the basic formulas, list of formulas, that is TVD for pressure calculation, TMD for volume calculation, then that is your TMD for volume calculation equal to total measured depth, then hydrostatic pressure, TVD into mud density into 0.0981, and gradient kilopascal per meter, that is mud density into 0.0981. Then we have the formation pressure, then we have equivalent circulating density. You can see the formulas. EC equivalent mud density, EMD, equal to total pressure divided by TVD, and BHP divided by TVD. Then EBHP, that is equal to HP plus APL. Then EBHP equal to HP minus swab pressure. Then EBHP equal to HP plus surge pressure. Then trip margin density increase equal to trip margin pressure required divided by true vertical depth divided by 0.0981. So these are the formulas, list of formulas utilized in well control. Then also calculations, we can see here gas expansion formula, that is Boyle's law, V into P1 equal to V2 into P2, that is Vt equal to V1 into P1 divided by P2. So V1, the initial pit gain entering the well bore, and P1 is the initial pressure acting on the influx, that is your formation pressure in kilopascal. So V2 is your expanded volume of gas, and P2 is the pressure acting on the gas. And some well control calculations you can see here, that is density increase equal to SI DPP divided by TVD divided by 0.0981, and KMD, kill mud density, equal to density increase plus OMD. And the remaining SIDPP equal to original SIDPP minus original SIDPP into Stokes pump divided by Stokes 2 bit. And barite record, you can see the formulas, or calcium carbonate, how much you are needed. That is equal to calcium carbonate into total volume. the number of sacks required for each barite equal to barite required divided by 40 kilogram per sack. So these are the formulas which are utilized. Then you can see here the specific formulas for the calculation. So number of sacks of calcium carbonate equal to calcium carbonate required divided by 25 kg per sack. So it depends on this sack size delivered to location. Then we are having the mixing rate equal to number of sacks divided by reduced circulating time. Then ICP, initial circulating pressure, equal to RSPP plus SADPP plus overall kiln in kilopascal. Then FCP, final circulating pressure. You can see the formula, RSPP kilopascal into KMD kilogram meter cube divided by OMD plus overall kiln, that is kilopascal. And the formula specific to concurrent method, that is density increase, FCP, and the remaining SADPP in kilopascal, or remaining SADPP kilopascal. So you can see the formula clearly, that is specific to concurrent method. Then next is your leak of calculation, leak of pressure equal to applied surface pressure plus HP at casing seat equal to LOG into casing depth. Leak of gradient equal to LOP divided by depth of casing, and equivalent mud density equal to leak of gradient divided by 0.0981, and MACP equal to LOP minus HP kilopascal, and MACP with increased mud density equal to LOP at shoe minus new HP at casing shoe. So next is your fluid level drop while pulling the dry and wet pipes. You can see here, pulling dry pipe, drop in fluid level equal to length of pipe into displacement divided by annular capacity plus pipe capacity, and loss of HP equal to drop in level into density into 0.0981. So these are the some calculations which are utilized in well control engineering. And similarly, pill pumping calculation, this is another formula, length of pill volume divided by drill pipe capacity, then differential pressure equal to length of pill into pill gradient minus mud gradient, etc. And accumulator calculation, so this is another important formula, fluid required value equal to shown, then total fluid required and the total accumulator size L equal to, you can see the formula very clearly, that is remaining pressure kilopascal into total fluid pressure divided by pressure on accumulator minus remaining pressure into pressure on accumulator divided by pre-charge pressure. Then number of bottles required, that is accumulator size in liters by bottle size. Then we have to use for nitrogen backup calculation, that is usable nitrogen equal to bottle pressure divided by remaining pressure minus 1 into bottle size in liter. So the total number of nitrogen bottles required, which is very important, that is fluid required without safety factor minus usable nitrogen bottles in liters. So this is another formula. Then we are also having the pump pressure calculation, P2 equal to P1 into SPM2 by SPM1 the whole squared. Then you can see here, next is kick gradient. You can see here, length of kick equal to pit gain by annular volume, and length of kick equal to SICP minus STBB divided by gradient of mud minus gradient of kick. So this is the simple formulas used for the calculation. And you can see the gas gradient, oil gradient, and water gradient values are shown. Then list of formula units, deca, newton, kilogram, liter, meter, square meter, cubic meter, and megapascal. Then there is example of brackets, bed mass, which tells us the brackets, which is the highest priority. So you can see here the brackets formulas, example 2, nested brackets. So this is the bed mass examples for components. Then next is the checklist for your used equipment for data sheets, the vertical wall, divided wall, vertical liner, divided liner, then well control operation record sheet, then well control kill sheet, that is casing, first circulation, then casing, second circulations for drillers, weighters, weight and weight and concurrent method, liner, then deep liner, then well control sheet graphics, then volumetric method kill sheet, then divided horizontal kill sheet. So you can see here the diagram, it shows the blank well sheet for well control. So you can see all the data required, true vertical depth, then intermediate casing, kickoff point, annular capacity, and pump specifications. And the right answer, you can see the intermediate casing, surface casing, the well diagram, you can see very clearly. Pump specification, so these are the thing: mud tank volume, pit gain, overall kill, shut in casing pressure, shut in drill pipe pressure, etc. Then next is your, this is your typical volume displacement, time strokes data, our kill sheet. You can see here in my past videos, we already explained, but you can go through this. This is your concurrent method. So you can see here ICP, FCP, SADPP, then what is the remaining SADPP at KOP, and RSPP with KMD at kickoff point. So all these which are utilized in your kill sheet. Then you can see here also the pump pressure drop. How do we can calculate in the kill sheet? Then the next one, you can see the concurrent method only. So barite requirements, how much is required? You can see, and circulating pressure calculations very clearly shown in the kill sheet. Then pump pressure drops for increase of per 100 strokes. Then you can see the second circulation. What are the data should be input? Then this is your kick data, well control operation sheet. You can see a record of kick data. Everything is shown, and circulating drill pipe pressures, RSPP, SADPP, ICP, FCP, etc. Then initial killing casing pressure, SACP, initial kill CP, then DPP record to control formation. Then final shut-in pressures, SADPP, SICP, and time. And this is the stroke graph, well control sheet graph. After the formulation of drill pipe pressure, can initiate the graph. That is MACP, maximum allowable casing pressure with kill mud, then strokes to beat from pre-record information, then reduced speed, ICP, FCP, final circulating pressure. Then strokes time, you can see here. So this is your important well control sheet for volumetric method. You can see here annular capacity, starting volume, volume of bleed, MACP, SACP, overall kill, pressure increase, total. So this is the migration rate of per circulation rate. You can see in the last bottom of the column. And next, so you can see here very clearly the time, steps 4, 3, etc. And volume of bleed also shown in the left hand side. And this is your driller's method, step 1. That is, you can see the diagram. Well shut in, pressure stabilized, then pump started, RSPP establishment, circulation, continues with gas to surface, then invading of fluid is circulated from the annulus. Then you can see here the pump stopped, the well shut in, and the drillless method, you can see here the well shut in, step one, then pump started, then Kilmer density, then pump stop, circulation return, and the wellbore displace. So these are the points which used in the well control engineering. So today's lecture we have seen only the basic acronyms, formulas, etc. in the well control engineering. Thank you. Subscribe my channel. We'll see more on our next lecture. Thank you.